This is a new episode of our series 5G Explained. In this video, we discuss the concept of CORESETs and how it applies to downlink control information. We will introduce CORESETs, look at the CORESET structure and characteristics, and how the PDCCH is mapped to it. We will discuss two different types of mapping, interleaved and non-interleaved, and explain how search spaces enable to further reduce the complexity of control information decoding at the UE. A control resource set, or CORESET, is a set of time frequency resources where PDCCH may be transmitted. CORESETs are semi-statically configured by the network. There can be many CORESETs in a carrier, and they can occur anywhere in the slot in the frequency range of the carrier, but they are at most 3 OFDM symbol long. PDCCH is transmitted within a CORESET. The picture here shows the CORESET in green, and the PDCCH may occupy part of all of CORESET frequency location at defined time instance. The basic unit for a CORESET is resource element groups. Resource element groups consist of 12 resource elements by one OFDM symbol. And they were introduced in another episode of this 5G Explained series about downlink control information. A CORESET spans a multiple of possibly non-contiguous groups of 6 resource blocks in frequency and between 1 and 3 contiguous OFDM symbols in time. A CORESET represents locations where a given device may receive PDCCH. Importantly, there may be no control transmission at some locations in time and frequency. To simplify control information search in the UE, actual PDCCH locations may be further restricted by search spaces, as explained later. Also, a CORESET may not span the whole bandwidth. This is particularly important because UEs in a cell may not support the whole bandwidth, which may be up to 400 MHz, but they still need to be able to decode control information. As control regions are flexible, 5G new radio supports frequency domain interference coordination between cells. What this means is that neighboring cells can plan their CORESET locations to avoid inter-cell interference affecting the control signal. A PDCCH is mapped to a specific CORESET. I'd like to summarize that fact by saying that orange can only be on top of green on this picture. As seen in the episode on downlink control information, a PDCCH occupies 1, 2, 4, 8, or 16 control channel elements, or CCEs. You may remember from that episode of the 5G Explained series that one CCE corresponds to 6 resource element groups. One of the PDCCH configuration parameters may specify a period for repeated occurrences. We are now going to look in more detail at some of the parameters that are provided by 5G new radio to specify a CORESET. The pictures on this and the next slides were generated with MathWorks 5G toolbox. Here we can see the CORESET in green. The time duration is specified to be 3 OFDM symbols. The frequency occupancy is specified in terms of groups of 6 resource blocks that are occupied, namely groups 0, 1, and 3. The gap in frequency corresponds to group 2, which is not occupied by this CORESET. Symbol allocations 0 and 7 mean that the CORESET is present starting at OFDM symbols 0 and 7, and it is 3 OFDM symbols long each time, as seen earlier. Finally, we can see the CORESET is allocated in slots 0 and 1. On this view of the same frequency time location, we also represent demodulation reference symbols, or DMRS, associated with the PDCCH in orange and the data channel, or PDSCH, in teal. DMRS are shown in yellow. Out of every set of 72 resource elements where a PDCCH is mapped, 54 are for PDCCH and 18 are for associated DMRS. We will look at DMRS in detail in another episode of this series, 5G Explained. On this final view of the CORESET, we can see the periodicity for the CORESET. Slots 0 and 1 are assigned, and the CORESET then repeats every 5 slots, as specified by the period. Here, we have a more detailed look at the PDCCH parameters. The first line specifies which CORESET the PDCCH is mapped to. The period shows that the PDCCH is mapped every 3 CORESET occurrences, and the allocated search space parameters indicates that the allocation is in occurrence number 0. Finally, from a time and frequency point of view, the PDCCH starts at CCE number 1, which is the second CCE, or group of 6 resource element groups, and it uses a granularity of 4, meaning that it includes 4 CCEs, or a total of 24 resource element groups. Note that CCE number 0 corresponds to the first CCE within the CORESET. Let us have an interactive look at those parameters with a utility that uses MathWorks 5G Toolbox. Here, we can quickly vary the CORESET and PDCCH or DMRS definition and observe the effect on the resulting 5G OFDM grid. We are looking at one subframe with a 15 kHz subcarrier spacing, and we can see the CORESET in green, the PDCCH in orange, the data channel or PDSCH in teal, and all associated DMRS in yellow. Let's change the subcarrier spacing to 30. Still showing one subframe. We now have 2 slots or 28 OFDM symbols in one subframe, and we can see further allocation of a PDCCH on the right. Let us now reduce the aggregation level for the PDCCH from 4 to 2, which means that we use fewer CCEs to encode the DCI, and look at the PDCCH in orange. The size of a PDCCH has been halved. It is now 2 CCEs, or 2 times 6 equals 12 resource element groups. As the CORESET is 3 symbols long, this means the PDCCH occupies 3 OFDM symbols in time by 4 resource blocks in frequency. If we change the CORESET duration in time from 3 to 2, we can see that the PDCCH, which still uses 12 resource element groups, is now shaped as a 2 symbols by 6 resource blocks, which is narrower and taller. Also, the PDCCH now occupies a higher percentage of the CORESET, as there is reduced control capacity. Let's have a larger view and represent 4 subframes or 8 slots. We can see the periodicity of a CORESET. It occupies symbols 0 and 7 in slots 0 and 1, and the period is 5 slots, which means that the same pattern occurs 5 slots later. If we change the period to 6 slots, we see the pattern move 1 slot to the right. There are many more options which you can explore in detail with MathWorks 5G Toolbox, but hopefully this short example helps making those parameters more concrete. 5G NR allows for interleaved CCE-to-REG mapping with different bundle sizes. What this means is that contiguous physical resources may not correspond to contiguous bits in the PDCCH. The interleaver defines a bundle size, which introduces a similar concept as resource block bundling for PDSCH. As a reminder, resource block bundling in PDSCH enables to specify blocks of resources that are guaranteed to have the same precoding. Resource block bundling for PDSCH is further discussed in another episode of this 5G Explained series about channel sounding. As mentioned earlier in this section, monitoring all CORESETs for all possible aggregation levels is too expensive for a UE to do. Further restrictions in the location and size of possible PDCCH are introduced via the concept of search spaces. A search space is a set of candidate control channels formed by CCEs. It specifies the aggregation level, which means the size, for each candidate. Search spaces apply to device-specific and common search spaces. Common search spaces contain information that is relevant to several or all UEs. Blind search is considered to be successful if the CRC checks and the content of the decoded DCI makes sense. Here's one example of possible search space. In this example, there are 5 search locations defined within this CORESET. The UE does not need to look for possible control information at all locations with all granularities. It only needs to look for a 2 CCE PDCCH at 3 locations, as well as 4 CCE PDCCH at another 2 locations. This saves considerable amount of time and power compared to searching through all groups of 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16 CCEs. This concludes this episode of the 5G Explained series on CORESETs.